another respected gentleman on the dais, or the Chief Vigilance Officer from our corporate center, Sri Ashu Kumar Ji, General Managers, Sri Prabodh Parikh, Sri Manikandan, DGM Vigilance, Sri Mohanty Sir. Just now we have another DGM Vigilance from Amaravati, Sri Vidyadhar Sir, other Deputy General Managers, senior functionaries, and my dear colleagues. Good afternoon to all of you. It was a pleasant surprise that I would be called to talk now, after almost all these stalwarts sitting on the dais have shared what is vigilance and why it should be there and so on. But I will go to the subject straight away, corruption-free India. The government of India under the leadership of the present Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, says that by 2022, that is another 5 years from now, India should become corrupt-free. He has already initiated certain actions in that direction, because he strongly believed that the black money is the offshoot of corruption, and to attack that, he took the strongest decision, very rarely among any prime minister, that is demonetization. How much results it yielded, I will not go into it. It is not my job at all. I will not go into it. But today I saw one article in India Today, which says that 45 major cities, they went and they made a survey. More than 1 lakh people were asked to give their responses. And 45% of them say that still they are paying bribe. One thing which really pleases all of us is all of them have said that the bribe they have paid is in the registration offices where the land, buildings, flats are registered. In the government offices, in the municipal corporations, and in the police stations, and not in banks. That is what gives us a lot of pleasure. I can very proudly say from this dais that State Bank of India has been a pioneer and has always been leading from the front to see that these corrupt practices do not enter the banking industry. And having said, under the leadership of our CGM Sri Hardayal Prasad Ji, Hyderabad Circle is in the forefront to see that such things do not happen in our bank. Credit goes to Sir. I am really proud to say that from this dais. We do not have any instances of corruption. There may be instances of fraud. That is different. I am not going to tell about that. But corruption is something which has got directly to do with our honesty and integrity. And all of us have to work together to see that the aim of the government, a corrupt-free India in 2022, has to be achieved. So we have already taken pledge and we are already moving ahead in that direction. And let us all once again rather rededicate ourselves to this cause and see that we will not allow this particular evil, which is really spoiling the growth of the country and the economy, to enter our banking industry, more so State Bank of India, and more particularly because we are in Hyderabad Circle. That is my sincere advice, my sincere aim, that is what I am looking to. And I really thank you, sir, for the role you have mentioned to the CVO, because he has come for the first time, the role we play as an organization to see that the systems and procedures are followed. In every meeting, we do have one particular session to take care of the vigilance aspect and the following of systems and procedures. I can only assure you that we will continue to do it, and we are there with you to see that this bank is the best in the entire world. Thank you very much.